name's Ocelot. Big boss. You know who I am. A certain man gave me a job to do. Two, actually. First was to get you out of that hospital. The second was to rescue the man himself. You remember? Your partner, 9 years ago, Kazuhira Miller. 9 years back, your private army came under attack by Cypher. You were considered dead. Until today, that is, when Cypher found you. And it's not just them. The whole world wants you dead. You'll have to join up with Miller. Build that private army of yours one more time. It's your only chance. First, we need to save Miller. He's in Afghanistan.
Afghanistan.
What, you can't keep up with world affairs in a coma? 4 years ago, the Soviets invaded Afghanistan. The Muslims are fighting back with Western support. Miller was training Mujahideen rebels when he was captured by the Soviets. The Reds' 40th Army. Troop strength somewhere around 100,000. Squad holding Miller set off near the Pakistan border yesterday. Now in 3 days, they'll reach the Soviet garrison. He'll be interrogated for a few more days, and it's off to a lager. Or left to rot in a ditch on Afghan soil. I give him 2 weeks. The job didn't mean anything to Miller. He only took it on to keep you safe. Well, there's our ride. Whaling ship. Had a pretty good deal on her once the IWC started raising a stink. That was 7 days to Port Kasim, another 3 overland. So we won't have much time once we're there. Don't take too long getting used to your new self. Hang on. Ha!
What's up, YouTube? Seven Shoguns here, back with some more Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain, Episode 2. I wanted to kind of just shut up for a second and let you guys listen to that beginning cutscene and everything. So we last episode, we beat the prologue, and these are our awards. We got the Ocelot's briefings, Men on Fire, and music tape. So we got some cassette tapes. You can get cassette tapes in this game and listen to them. They're basically like the codex of the previous game, so a lot of the backstory and information in this game are through these cassette tapes, so you might listen to a few just to kind of get some backstory, but for the most part, if you have the time, you're playing this game yourself, you should definitely take a look at these to get some more information. We also got an emblem. We will be designing our own emblem for this game. Basically, it all comes down to the mother base building stuff, which we'll talk about in a second. Switching camera position. Press R to switch camera position from right to left. Yeah, it's an old school one right there for Metal Gear fans. So one, the Phantom Limbs.
Under total Soviet control. Miller's been captive for 10 days. Not much time left.
Weather will clear shortly.
Storm's passing. Solo infiltration of the Soviet main ground forces. Should be the perfect warm-up. Kazuhira Miller is being held in Dawandehar to the north. Check its location now. Take out your eye drawer. You see Wandi on the map? That's where they're keeping Miller. Only problem is, we don't know his exact location. Finding it is your first priority. Go ahead and close the eye drill. Got your binoculars? Or should I say, your int scope? See the village? Straight ahead? To the right. Look up. All right, that's the village. If you see something through the binoculars and you need more information, just give me a call. I'll tell you anything I can about it. That's Violo Village, the Violo Calais. The villagers fled the war and evacuated a while back. Since then, it's become a base for the Soviets' 40th Army. A few days ago, Miller was taken through there, en route towards Dawandehar. You may be able to pick up the trail there. It's worth a shot. Put a marker on it so you don't lose track of where it is.
Marker
wrong target,
placed.
Boss. Use your binoculars to focus in on Davialo Calais village and mark it.
Marker
good.
Placed.
Now you won't have to worry about getting lost along the way. He can't have much left in him. I give him 3 days, tops. If we fail, and he dies, we lose our chance of revenge. But we need more intel. If you just go charging into Dohondahar, you'll be putting both your lives at risk. See what you can find out first. The Soviets have other outposts, not just the one you saw. Afghanistan is a big place. I expect you'll become quite familiar with those binoculars as you plan your next move. How and where you make it, well, that's up to you. From here on out, you're on your own. You're a legend in the eyes of those who live on the battlefield. That's why you have to handle this mission yourself. Put those 9 years behind you, and return as Big Boss. That's how Kaz would want it. I'll be sending additional intel by radio. Stay sharp. Not one of Miller's bodyguards survived. And they were good. All we found on the scene were their corpses and knees. You'll be missing them. And you're his only hope of getting them back. Now go! Let the legend come back to life.
Nice. All right. Welcome to Afghanistan, you guys. You can press square to go faster on your horse. Let's make our way over here, man.
Hold it. It was a Soviet guard post. There are bound to be guards. Take a look with your binoculars. Put the enemy in the center of your field of view. That's marking. Focus on a thread and it'll be marked automatically. You can mark enemies and vehicles by zooming in with your binoculars or camera. Once they're marked, you'll also see their positions on the map. Security at that guard post is relatively light. Looks like the perfect place for a warm-up. Yeah. Try to remember the ways you used to deal with enemies. Anytime you need advice, just give me a call.
Alright, so it's our first time picking out an enemy. Remember the prologue, you can press X to crouch and hold down to go prone.
Sight, sound, keep all your enemy senses in mind. When you're near an enemy, stay low and move slowly.
I'm gonna try and get behind this guy.
Boss, you don't understand what he said? I guess that makes sense. It looks like that horn stuck in your head has impacted the language center of your brain. If only we had a recruit with the Russian interpreter skill, we could get by with simultaneous interpretation.
Alright, so we can't really interpret this guy, so we'll just knock him out for now.
Don't leave bodies out in the open. Find some place to drop them out of sight.
So a porta potty over here. Just go ahead and
a portable toilet. If you're gonna hide inside, watch the enemy doesn't decide to use it. Same goes for hiding downed enemies in it.
Just go ahead and throw them in there. Alright, we see another guy though over here. So we'll go ahead and mark him with the binoculars. That's a good habit you're going to want to get into, for sure. And exactly the same thing, we're going to go ahead and sneak over to him. Let's try taking this guy out. What do we got here? We have a pistol we can use to put him asleep. We can also just kill him. But we're gonna go ahead and try and put this guy to sleep.
Guard post captured.
Nice. When you hear that guard post captured, that basically means there's no one left in that guard post, so you're free to kind of walk around and do whatever you want at that point. We do want to put him somewhere so no one's going to hear him like you said, so I'll try it here. Just drop him down here.
Those materials are already processed. They should come in handy sooner or later. Why not start gathering them?
Get some processed materials while we're at it. See if there's anything else over here. I see something shiny. Ooh, what is this?
That's a rough diamond. Good find. It'll fetch a high price.
Circle's also how you reload. Or, I think that's B on Xbox.
Planning to walk the whole wilderness on foot? Use your horse.
Yeah. So if you hold down L1, you'll have different commands you can do. If you press, up, you can kind of lure enemies, like, by knocking, essentially. And if you have a buddy, like your horse, you can talk to them. So if you press right, I can call for my horse. Horse? Alright. Alright, yeah, don't mind that slight pause there. Just had to... something real quick.
Extraction arrived.
You're almost at the enemy outpost, Violo Village. The village is crawling with enemy soldiers. Don't just go waltzing in. Whoa. Start with some recon. Is there anywhere that overlooks the village?
Up there. Also over there.
How about it? Can you see the village from there? Use the binoculars to recon the place. Look at where the enemies are stationed. Look at their gear. Take it all in. There should be a command post somewhere. See any buildings with tighter security? If there are clues to Miller's whereabouts, I'll bet you can find them in there. Shells travel in a curved trajectory, meaning they hit from up above you.
It's definitely not what we were looking for as far as intel, but okay.
That's communications equipment used by the outpost CP. It must be how they keep in touch with headquarters. If you destroy it, you might be able to cut off the CP from their HQ.
Alright, that's not bad. Let's go ahead and drop down here. I only got two guards, so I'm not sure. Wait, hold on. There we go. There's one more guard, but... I might be able to just sneak past this guy completely. Now, as far as this gameplay, you know, I'm gonna try and kill no one, but, things do go sour often, so you never know with this game. I think the trick really is just to play as best you can.
That's a type of medicinal plant. Bring it back to base. It's sure to be useful sometime.
That guy's moving. Gotta be careful here. I'm gonna get seen. Now, I don't know if there's anyone looking at him right now.
Sun's down already. It goes without saying that darkness is good for infiltration. But your vision will be affected just the same. Keep your guard up, or who knows when you'll bump into an enemy.
These guys real quick.
Antenna. There could be intel files of some kind in there.
It's also a cassette right here. Just gonna go ahead and take that. Also, be careful that opening doors does make noise, so you want to try and move slow, and that'll let the door sort of open slowly and not necessarily make too much noise.
Hey, that's
a gun. Found the intel we're looking for.
So you picked up
intel
an intel file.
Extraction.
Now we know where Miller
at
is.
Mother base.
I'm marking it on your iDroid.
The map has been updated. Marker removed.
That's the building, boss. That's where they're holding Miller.
Marker placed.
Alright, so now we know on the map, so let's go ahead and make our way over there. Now, it is nighttime now, so it'll be a little bit easier to maneuver, so it'll be less enemy activity, but there's still enemies, so you gotta be really careful. Alright. Like that. Things will just happen sometimes, and you gotta be prepared. I got kinda lucky there. Back up, but whatever, it's fine.
Hey,
want to leave, though, because that guy's body is over there, and I don't think we're gonna... It's worth trying to pick him back up, so we're just gonna go ahead and go. Be mindful. See any guards. So we're gonna go ahead and call our horse pretty soon. Let's drive over here. Not in the clear yet. Alright. So if you keep running. Also, when you call your horse, the horse will call right up next to you, too. So it's nice and convenient. I do see two people over here. I think a good tip also, too, is you'll know when someone shows, when you're near enemies, if the kind of music starts to change a little bit. You can also do horse stealth and hide on the back of your horse if you press the X button while riding your horse, and that helps... Keep your stealth a little bit. I think we're gone, so we should be okay. I do see some light though, so.
Yeah.
Yep. It's always good to be careful. Yeah. See some music there we can get. Again.
It's an enemy guard post. Watch yourself.
I would say it's best to not engage people if you don't have to. And like another thing is right now, diamonds. We don't have Fultoning, we haven't started recruiting people yet, all that good stuff we're gonna be doing, so it's sort of not worth even fighting these guys. Just going around them. Really, it's just the best method to use. Alright. Well, now we're past them. Yeah. The biggest thing about this game now, you know, being open world, is that, you know, you have so much freedom. Before, maybe that would have been a tight corridor, so you kind of had to engage those guys. But now, because of the freedom, we don't really have to. And we have the ability... to really just go around them. So, I would say if you don't want to avoid, if you don't want to start a confrontation, just avoid them. There's no point in even fighting them at all. So, making our way. We're almost here now.
You've reached one day. They've got Miller locked up in that town. Check your eye droid for his location. I hope to hell he's alright. He's not your average client.
Alrighty, so we've made it. Again, we know on the map that that's the sort of building that he's in.
That's the building, boss. That's where they're holding Miller.
Alright, so let's go ahead and scout this place. Somewhere in there. There's a guard right there. Spotlight. See a guy right here. It's really important to try and mark as many people as you can. It's kind of hard to do this at night. So a good strategy actually would be to use your phantom cigar to kind of control the time of day. And you could make it daytime and then use phantom cigar to make it daytime so you can kind of pinpoint all of the different enemies. And then at night, you can see where they are because guards do have shift changes depending on the time of day. However, I don't believe they're gonna send in new guards, so you'll mark everyone, and then when they change shifts, you'll be able to keep track of where they are. So, the silver here is a pretty good path around, but there seems to be more guard activity on this side. However, if we go on the right, there's this one guy, and this guy. For the most part, it looks like it's pretty open, so we're going to try and attack from the right. Like I said, don't forget also, your tranquilizer is suppressed. Did he just hit his own dude? Dude. What? I did not know that that could happen. I did not know they could actually hit somebody like that. Like that. All right, so don't mind that skip right there. I actually had to restart the mission because some things happened that weren't the way I really wanted them to go. So hopefully I won't be restarting missions too often. I don't really mind showing failure because, to be perfectly honest with you, I'm gonna fail a lot in this game. I mean, I like Metal Gear and the series, and I love the Metal Gear story, but stealth games aren't really my cup of tea. I'm more of the kind of action game, run into a room and kill everyone type of guy, so going into something completely stealthy is a little difficult for me. But that's one of the things about Metal Gear that's great later on, is that you actually have the ability to do that. You can run into a scenario and just kill everything. It's something you couldn't do in previous Metal Gear games, but for now, we haven't gotten that far yet, so let's try and just stay stealthy for the most part. I'm trying to avoid this this light here. I think he's turning back now. Okay. Again, we're gonna do our best to remain stealthy. Especially because, you know, this is like the first real mission. There's no reason why we should get caught here. Other than just user error. Which, there is bound to be some user error. I mean, let's be honest here. Come on. I definitely did not want to call my horse. I wanted to call the enemy over, but whatever. I guess that works too.
That's tarragon, a type of medicinal plant. It contains trace amounts of a benzodiazepine derivative that's the active ingredient in pentazamine.
Thank you.
destination.
So we found him.
Kaz. No more use for me, huh? Kaz, it's me. I'm here to get you out. Snake. They do something to your eyes? No, it's just bright as all. Took you so long. We'll talk, but not here.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
You've secured the target. I'll send the chopper to get you out. Make your way to the RV. You can check the location on your iDroid.
Mission info has been updated.
Alright, so there is a ton of glare on my screen right now, and it's making it very difficult to see, so... we're gonna try and get this done, but...
You look well. Age hasn't slowed you down.
That was really close, because literally, like I said, the glare on my TV, I couldn't see, so I was just guessing.
I've been waiting 9 years to hear him. Kept you waiting, huh? Come on. Save for all time's sake.
Maybe later? We're getting the hell out of here right now, Kaz. Something shiny there. Ooh, I'll pick that up. There goes our ride.
This is B-Quad. Arriving shortly at LZ.
Not look good.
It's them.
The frogs? From there just saw it fall?
Boss, watch out. It's the skulls.
Oh.
Don't let them find us.
Extraction.
The skulls.
Whatever that mist is, it's all around you. We can't see through it. I'm changing the RV so it's outside the mist. Get over there. The chopper will be waiting.
Now, you normally would go this way. But you actually can't, because that leaves the mission area. So, my thing is, how are you supposed to get around these guys? I think there's actually a side thing you can do, is to get around them without being seen. but...
Run, boss. You've got to lose him.
I'm pretty sure it's impossible. Yeah. There's the chopper. Woo! Oh man, they're moving, you guys. They're gone.
The mist is cleared, and it looks like they're gone.
I don't know how, you guys, but somehow we definitely survived that.
That's the unit that attacked us before. They came at us real fast in the same kind of mist. Our men, survivors from 9 years ago, were wiped out in minutes.
All right. I don't know where they're at, but it's them.
No mistake.
What?
Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
Phantom Limb. So like I said, yeah, we did do that one retry in the middle there. I did end up cut that out. Just because, again, it wasn't really worth showing. I just got seen. I didn't really want to show that because this is like the beginning of the game. So, but like I said, there'll be plenty of mess-ups. I doubt very seriously we can do this entire game with stealth, so I'm probably going to be getting seen a lot, so don't expect cuts, you know, often, but just for this time, I decided to cut that out. But there you go, guys. Episode 1, The Phantom Limbs, The Phantom Menace, has been taken care of. My dog just walked in, so that's cool. So let me know what you guys think down in the comments down below. That'll do it for this episode of Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain. I hope you guys enjoyed it. See what the next screen is. Got some more GMP. It's good. Good. Increased our heroism. It's not bad. Alright, guys. Thank you guys for watching. If you like this video, go ahead and subscribe. It helps out a lot. And, like the video. Liking it definitely helps a lot. And if, you want to see more, come back to see more videos. Alright, until next time, Seven Shoguns out.